It is a cold and rainy night in Seattle, Washington. But across town at Heck Edmondson Pavilion, the evening is just beginning to heat up as the 10th-rated Arizona Wildcats are in town to battle the Washington Huskies. And I believe they are ready for some basketball. Hi, everybody. I'm Steve Fizziak. This is the coach, George Ravlinkin. Washington might be the scariest team to play in the conference right now. I mean, Todd McCullough showed UCLA the strength of this team by scoring 26 points, grabbing 21 rebounds. But tonight he goes against the guy who stopped him, A.J. Bramlett, the conference's best defensive post player.
Well, A.J. Bramlett will use his foot quickness to defense Todd McCullough in this game, Steve. He's going to use a variety of maneuvers. He's going to play behind him and get help. A ball rotates, he's going to go back, he's going to front him. He'll get help from the backside. As we see right here, he's fronting him, but he's got help in the back, Steve. Everywhere Bramlett plays him, he'll get weak side support. They'll also double team the ball down and low, force McCullough to throw the ball back out, keep Bramlett out of foul trouble.
McCullough only scored 8 points in their first meeting. Meantime, Jason Terry is coming home, grew up in Seattle, was a popcorn vendor at the old Husky games, almost went to Washington, and said he goes to Arizona and he's one of the best players in the league.
Well, Steve, early before the season, Terry got an Arizona schedule. He circled two games he thought were the most important to him. Tonight's game and UCLA at the end of the season. He really wants to showcase his talent, and his final game here in Seattle, his hometown.
He scored 30 against Washington last time they met in Tucson, Arizona. Watch for Deion Lewton, but Mr. Terry is the guy for this moment. Let's check the starting lineups. Arizona has two dynamic freshmen in Michael Wright and Richard Jefferson who have combined for 26 points and 13 rebounds per game. Seniors Bramlett and Terry make them go, but the freshmen must provide some offense. Lewton and Watts have to help McCullough offensively, and true freshman Senque Carey has just had a great last month. How about your key matchup, Coach?
Well, we have two Seattle high school products. They once dreamed of playing in the same backcourt in college. Tonight, they're going to be engaged in a bitter battle for personal bragging rights and a big win in the Pac-10.
Terry went to Seattle Franklin High School. Donald Watts went to Lake Washington. And Donald's coach, Bob Bender. First time he has been over 500 at Washington, and it came with that 93-83 win over UCLA. There's Lute Olson, 16th season in Arizona. What a wonderful job he has done. His last game beat California, 91-74. They out-rebounded the Bears by 16, and Jason Terry was fabulous. He has been named the Pac-10 Conference's Player of the Week, averaging 27.5 points per game. There's young Richard Jefferson, who will be matched up for the real test tonight against the high-scoring Deion Lewton. Arizona goes in the blue, Washington in the white. Bramlett against Chris Walcott for the jump, even though Walcott is 4 inches shorter than Todd McCullough. Senque Carey took it right away from Michael Wright and gets the layup. He has played some excellent basketball since the loss at Arizona when he scored a career-high 19. And Carey will start on Jason Terry. The alley-oop is knocked away. Bramlett gets it back and misses. McCullough, who had 21 rebounds against UCLA, has his first. Deion Lewton. Oh, they're pulling the trigger quickly.
Well, both of these teams are good transition teams. They like to shoot the three-point shot out of transition, and they'll bury it.
Michael Wright got low and scores.
Arizona likes to move the ball up the court quickly, beat the defense up so they don't have to feel the full sting of the defense.
Arizona staying in the man defense. Reuben Douglas defending carry. And the ball knocked free. A steal by A.J. Bramlett. Jason Terry. It spins out.
And that's a good example of what I talked about, Steve. Shooting the three in transition.
Richard Jefferson comes flying in. Bramlett tries to knock it away from McCullough. And A.J. gets it back. Boy, he has shown just remarkable growth from when he arrived as a freshman from Albuquerque, New Mexico. Shot clock is right now at 19, so plenty of time. This is Bramlett working against McCullough. Jump hook does not go. Second rebound for Tom.
Bramlett's got to attack McCullough. He won't have a lot of success shooting over top of him. He's got to attack his body.
Although trying to enter that basketball to Todd McCullough, he has just been denied. So Donald Watts fires a three and puts Washington up by three. Terry in the lane scores his first basket. Donald Watts!
And there's that personal battle we spoke about at the top of the broadcast, Steve.
Watts against Terry. Donald Watts has hit a three and now a slashing dunk to the hoop. And here's a guy who they really missed. Remember when he had sprained his ankle in December, missed about four games? He's come back and come back strong, particularly in conference play.
Well, Steve, he's their best perimeter defender. They need him at both ends of the court, not just at the offensive end of the floor.
Watts again flying by Terry, but Jason comes from behind and knocks it out of bounds.
Steve, I suspect somewhere down in Palo Alto, California, sits Mike Montgomery as he watches Donald Watts penetrate by Jason Terry.
Thank you, Terry.
Mike Montgomery seated in front of a TV with a yellow legal pad. You know who he's rooting for, Steve.
It is Washington 9, Arizona 4. The Stanford Cardinal winning last night over California with a game and a half lead over the Arizona Wildcats. There is Bob Bender. He said one of the keys to this game, and it seems like both coaches want to get the postman, the opponent's postman, in foul trouble. Bramlett's been attacking McCullough. McCullough really working hard at the offensive end, just trying to get open. He hasn't touched the ball yet on the offensive end. But they're going to try and go high low from Walcott to McCullough, but it's denied. Cynthia Carey hits the three.
Steve, an hour before the game, Cynthia Carey was out here working on his jump shot. It's paying off early for him.
He's 3 for 3 with 7 points. Michael Wright gets low to score. But you might remember, Washington had a 14-point lead in Tucson. And my goodness, the Wildcats came back so quickly. Washington 5 for 6. Luton short. Jefferson rebounds.
Jason Terry has his own rooting section here. There's about 50 family members and friends all purchased tickets for this game.
Nice move by Carey. He almost faked a bounce pass over to Deion Luton and brought the dribble right to the middle, and he scores himself. He has 9 points.
But Steve, the young man might be a freshman, but his game is the game of a junior, playing with supreme confidence at both ends of the floor.
But that little movement where he was trying to pass it froze Terry. He had to really respect the defender.
Steve, all of a sudden, Cynthia Carey is a threat to Michael Wright for freshman player of the year.
You're absolutely right. Now, Wright might say wrong, but right now, the man who has been so right is Donald Watts and Cynthia Carey. He's pointing to the team in the lead. The Washington Huskies by 8 over Arizona. Jason Terry stays on the floor with A.J. Bramlett. They tried the pick. There was no roll as they was all designed for Terry's three.
Washington doing a nice job of sending all five players to the defensive board in an effort to deny Arizona's second shot opportunities.
And away from the basketball, there is a call that will go against the Huskies. There is Lute Olson, who was very concerned about this basketball game. He really felt that Washington really deserved the favorite's role in this game.
Well, there's no question that if Washington wins, it would not necessarily be an upset. Washington's a 2.5-point favorite in this game, Steve. A little bit surprising.
They're unbeaten at home this year. 8-0 at Heckad, and they won their other game in Seattle.
Well, that would explain the rationale of the 2.5-point favorite.
Here's Rick Anderson in the game now at the off-guard spot. A.J. Bramlett hooks it right in the face of Todd McCullough.
As always, Lute Olson starts off early, building his offense from the inside out because he knows later on it'll play dividends from the perimeter.
Walcott faking the three as Michael Wright on him defensively. They get the ball to Donald Watts again. The next time he scores, he will have 1,000 in his Husky career. And he has it right wing. Shot clock's down to 12. There's the three. And it's no good. Michael Wright high for the rebound. Terry stays on Jason Terry. Richard Jefferson. He was defended extremely well by Donald Watts. The ball is thrown away. Washington now going with Donald Watts. Senku Carey will now come out of the game. They'll bring Michael Johnson in the game. That will move Watts to the point. And Deion Luton and Chris Walcott and Todd McCullough will be on the front line. Todd McCullough, he has rarely touched the ball on offense.
But what they're trying to do is make McCullough have to work as hard as possible every down time down the court to gain offensive position.
Michael Johnson for three.
Bob Bender said he has been a much improved player over the last 20 days. He has supreme offensive confidence, which he lacked earlier in the season.
Bramlett misses the hook, but McCullough let him get so deep. And it allows the offensive rebound to go to Rick Anderson, who scores.
Thus far, Arizona has pretty much forced Washington into a jump shooting offense. There's their first inside scoring opportunity.
And he finally touches the basketball. And as soon as he does, he picks up the foul from A.J. Bramlett.
Well, to Todd McCullough's credit, he continues to move, work, secure position. He locks Bramlett high, throw over top. He attacks Bramlett, puts his body on him first, and then goes for the shot.
And you know, the fans would have exploded had McCullough made the basket. But coach, this is even more important, the fact that he picks up the foul.
Absolutely. It's worth the 2 points that were denied.
Justin Wessel comes in for Arizona, and he will take the place
of Rick Anderson. Rick Anderson went out with a sprained ankle.
Chris Walcott comes out for Washington, and he's replaced by Thalo Green. McCullough gives Washington an 8-point lead. Now they've switched Watts over on Jason Terry. We welcome the Fox Sports Net fans who have been watching this game in New York City. We are at Heck Edmondson Pavilion in Seattle, Washington for the 10th rated Arizona Wildcats and the Washington Huskies. Steve Fisiak along with George Raveling. Michael Wright, the big freshman forward who is the leading scorer and rebounder as far as freshmen go in the conference, is at the free throw line and misses his first. The foul went against Todd McCullough. Now Richard Jefferson leaves the Arizona lineup. Gene Edgerson will come in at the next buzzer.
There's a new twist for Arizona. Full court pressure.
And now they've got a 3-on-1, and McCullough hits the jam.
The two choices a team has against the press: attack the press to get the ball across half court, attack the press to score. Obviously, the Huskies attacking the press to score.
They did a nice job breaking the pressure as Jason Carey rolls in the three. The pressure that UCLA supplied on Sunday, and it resulted in so many free throws, 47 free throws to 16, because when they got back on defense, UCLA was fouling. Deion Luton, that's a two.
And Steve, that's a tough matchup for Arizona. Michael Wright on Deion Luton. All of a sudden, Michael Wright is no longer a low post defender. He's a perimeter defender. He's not used to playing that far away from the basket.
Do you think it'll be long before they get Thalo Green over on him? Thalo Green is defending Michael Wright. Let's see who Wright picks up when he comes down the floor.
And that's what I was talking about.
Now he'll move over and take Thalo Green. And Green's trying to flash by him. Nice layup by Thalo Green. Reuben Douglas missing in the drive. A foul will be called against Washington. It goes against, oh, it's an offensive foul. All the players were staying back, but the lead official, Dave Libby, overruled and said it is an offensive foul. We'll be right back. Washington has an 8-point lead on the Arizona Wildcats. Their biggest lead has been 9. But at Stanford, they led by 9 and lost. At Arizona, Washington was ahead by 14 points in the first half. But Jason Terry hit a 3 as the buzzer sounded to cut it to 47-45. And Arizona would then go on to win on that Richard Jefferson tip-in in Tucson. Thalo Green with the basketball with Michael Johnson, Donald Watts, Todd McCullough, and Greg Clark now in the game. And a travel is called against Todd McCullough.
A good example of what we talked about in the open introduction to the game, Steve, that when McCullough gets the ball, they're going to double him. Weak side help will come immediately. McCullough turned and moved into the weak side help and was unable to get the ball down on the floor before he walked.
And they've got to get him the basketball because A.J. Bramlett is on the bench. The only size they have is 6'6", Eugene Edgerson, and 6'7", Justin Wessel. Terry flashing to the hoop and scoring. Jason Terry with 7 points. He's now 3 of 7 from the floor.
Poor help defense by Todd McCullough. He allowed Jason Terry to turn the corner when his man set the screen.
Right now, Edgerson's on McCullough. He's 6'6" tall. And Watts, flashing to the hoop, will pick up an Arizona foul. It was the second personal foul on Reuben Douglas. Todd McCullough will now leave the Washington lineup as they go smaller with Thalo Green, Greg Clark, and Chris Walcott on the front line with Michael Johnson and Donald Watts staying in the backcourt. Senku Carey has been on the sideline for a while.
And I'm sort of intrigued as to what the reason for that is.
Johnson gets his own rebound back and has it knocked away. And Michael with the steal. Walcott says, let's run some half court.
Nice patience by Donald Watts. He could have forced that jumper up, but he waited.
Greg Clark short. Wright with the rebound, his third of the game.
job of keeping Jason Terry from getting into a comfortable offensive rhythm.
Jefferson can't hold onto the basketball. Watts picks it up. Jason Terry staying on Donald.
With these two lineups on the floor, you look for a lot more perimeter offense with cutters breaking down the middle, such as what just happened.
Oh, the crowd wanting a goaltend. They will not get the call. This crowd is really into it today.
There's no question that that was basket interference. That ball was taken off the rim. Supreme hustle by Eugene Edgerson.
See if they clear out for Donald Watts, as he has a bigger but not as quick Richard Jefferson on him. Thalo Green, about a 10-footer, rolls out. And Michael Wright with another rebound.
Right now, the 10 players on the floor, Michael Wright is certainly the dominant rebounder.
He's got five. That time, Greg Clark went high to pull it down.
Donald Watts continues to show nice offensive discipline.
Donald misses the three. It goes out of bounds off Walcott's hands. So Washington still with a 6-point lead. And they're going to give it to Washington. They say it was last touched by Arizona. Arizona with the basketball. 8 minutes, 15 seconds to go first half. Steve Fisiaka, George Raveling in Seattle, Washington. Rick Clark could not hold on. A 6-point lead for the Huskies.
Open looks at the basket have been few and far between, Steve, for Arizona. Right now they're shooting 42% on 8-for-19. Excellent defense by the Washington Huskies. And they're keeping the ball out of Jason Terry's hands.
A.J. Bramlett, meantime, is back in the game. They're saying no basket. The foul was prior to the shot. And they're saying it is the against Todd McCullough. That will be his second personal foul. 8 minutes remaining first half. Will Bob Bender get him out of there before his third? A.J. Bramlett really going to work. He's had some tough luck as he's had very good looks at the hoop. It's been almost 3.5 minutes since the last Washington field goal. Watts is going to try and take it himself. Spins it over to Greg Clark. Loose for three. He hits. Washington has tied their biggest lead of the game at 9 points. 27-18, but Jason Terry trying to change that as Jason picks up the foul from Deion Luton.
The crowd is so loud here. Lute Olson was trying to signal from the bench a set play. He was yelling for Jason Terry's attention, but Jason couldn't hear him.
So Terry did the wise thing and took it himself. Remember the meeting in Tucson? Jason hit a Arizona record, 12 of 12 from the free throw line, to go with his 30 points that night. He has just put up those kinds of numbers every single night in conference play. Of you from Fox Sports Ohio watching the Dayton Temple basketball game. Steve Fisiak with George Raveling in a great first half as the Washington Huskies take on the Arizona Wildcats, and it's the Huskies by 11. Richard Jefferson picked up his first foul, sending Luton to the line. And Luton tried to nail the old-fashioned three-point play. Deion for three. Look at that. A 5-point play. Actually, four. He made one. No, it's a 6-point play.
Whatever it was big.
Yeah, our math may be bad, but they scored a lot of points in that one possession.
And everyone in this sellout crowd is on their feet.
Rick Anderson tips it in. Arizona has been dominating the boards, but they are down by 12 points. Chris Walcott wide open. Donald Watts grabs the rebound and is fouled by Richard Jefferson. Time out on the floor. Bob Bender likes the lead, but he had a 14-point cushion and lost in Arizona. Every seat taken here at Heck Edmondson Pavilion, including a couple of guys who will go back to work tomorrow. Gary Payton and Vin Baker of the Seattle Supersonics very interested in how Washington is going to fare against Arizona. And a lot of these Huskies work out with those guys in the offseason.
And Steve, right now the supreme decision for Bob Bender is, should I bring Todd McCullough back before the half is over, or should I leave him on the bench?
McCullough has two fouls. Bramlett has one.
Guess that's why they pay coaches well.
Well, Washington on an 11-4 run the last 5 minutes. Rick Anderson charges into his man, and we're going Washington's way.
Rick Anderson penetrates. Now, right there, he should have hit the jump stop and taken the short jumper. What he would have done is drew the defense to him. It would have opened up the underneath area for the drop down to Michael Wright. Good offenses cause defenses to make difficult decisions, Steve.
A switch for Arizona as they take Richard Jefferson, who has two fouls in the game, and bring in Justin Wessel. Thalo Green will be at the free throw line, and Thalo, only a 47% foul shooter. He misses the first. It is knocked out to Justin Wessel.
And what we have on the floor now for Arizona is a poor jump shooting team.
Jason Terry goes inside Michael Wright. He was fouled as he took the shot. The ball fell out of his hand, and then he slapped it off the glass, and it went in.
Michael Wright's a big, wide-body, low-post guy. He saddles up in there, attack, attack, attack. Coaches teach big men, be a three-point player. And Michael Wright learned his lesson well. 3 points.
He cuts it to nine. I remember you saying the thing you liked about him, even if there's a bad call by the official, his face doesn't change.
Oh, no, if you look at Michael Wright, you can't tell if Arizona's ahead or behind.
Oh, a nice pick and roll, and results in the hands of Chris Walcott for two.
Nice jump stop and power move by Chris Walcott.
Terry gives it inside to A.J. Bramlett. Terry is just unbelievable. He went right into A.J. and jump stopped and just kind of flipped it off to him. Donald Watts misses. Terry to right. Wright fumbles with it. Can't hold on this time. Wessel gets it and almost scored and will wind up at the free throw line.
This time of year, when you get into February, teams are either getting better or they're getting worse. Very few teams remain the same, and these two teams have gotten better in the last 25 days.
Well, Arizona, they have a record of 15-3. Meantime, Washington has a record of 12-7. They've got 9 games left. And, Coach, I really think Bob Bender has to win at least 6 of those to equal the number of victories they had last year when they went 20-10 and made the Sweet 16, beating Xavier and Richmond.
Well, as you notice, the NCAA selection committee looks at how you play in the last 10 games, the strength of your schedule, how you play against top 25 teams, and your overall record. So based on those criteria, Washington's not in bad shape.
Not at all, because they have beaten two top 20s this year.
And they're working on one right here.
Terry lobs it low. A.J. Bramlett. He misses the hook. Anderson has just done an excellent job on the offensive glass. He has two tip-ins for buckets, and this offensive rebound may result in two made free throws.
Well, the five players Arizona has on the floor right now, they're very active offensive rebounders. There's Rick Anderson coming down the lane with a vengeance after that rebound.
You know, so much was said about Michael Wright and Richard Jefferson and Reuben Douglas and Travis Wilson, but this kid's not a bad freshman either.
A bad freshman? He's a good freshman.
Thank you. It is Anderson, Edgerson, Bramlett, Wessel, and Terry on the floor for the Wildcats. Clark gives it off. Luton can't finish, gets his own rebound, has it swatted away, and Clark gets it back. Chris Walcott scores over Jason Terry. Terry misses the three. The one thing I've noticed in the last six games by Washington, there's great offensive awareness on the team. And we didn't see that, particularly in that Arizona State game right prior to the Arizona game. We really started their hot streak.
Well, not only is there good offensive awareness, but there's good ball movement, excellent patience, and decision-making.
And that three by Donald Watts gives him over 1,000 for his career. That's his dad, Slick Watts, the former great Sonic. Donald with the steal. Son to dad to son to Luton, and it is over the backboard.
Donald Watts said to Luton, my fault, I should have given you a bounce pass.
But Donald Watts has been leading the Washington Huskies to an 11-point lead over Arizona. Washington has an 11-point lead over the number 10-rated Arizona Wildcats.
Bob Bender is a by-the-book coach. He believes in critical games, key players with two fouls. You take them out, you keep them out for the remainder of the half.
Their replacements, guys like Michael Johnson, Chris Walcott, Thalo Green have done an excellent job. I mean, they've got four littles on the floor right now. The biggest man, Walcott, at 6'7". Trying to take his man, and that's what's going to happen when you've got five littles with one big as your opponent.
And that's what happens when you catch the ball, read the defense, and have good patience. Turn, face the defense, attack the basket.
Luton with Terry on him.
I'm really impressed with Donald Watts, how he can weave in and out of his role, one time playing the off guard, the next time playing the point guard, and understanding what his role is.
Michael Johnson misses with 8 seconds left in the shot clock. Washington by nine. Is this the run that Arizona has been so famous for this year? Anderson down low. Bramlett. Bramlett loses it, and he's tied up. And he calls a timeout. That's a senior. A 20-second timeout called by A.J. Bramlett with two Huskies all over him.
Now here comes Rick Anderson off. He knows he should have taken that shot, but he dumped it down into A.J. Bramlett.
A.J. Bramlett goes to the sideline.
Much of Washington's ability to secure this 9-point lead has been accompanied by good decision-making and easy shots.
Michael Wright with a good decision. Go to the boards as hard as you can.
Washington has 5 steals in the first half.
Michael Wright has 12 points and 6 rebounds. Oh, pretty pass by Phalo Green to Chris Wolcott. The air picked at the foul. He'll have 2 shots.
Boy, Terry has jet-like speed to the basket off the dribble. Once he made up his mind he was going to go to the basket, he just blew by Luton. That long crossover dribble, take it to the hole, force the defense to make a decision. Do they let me score or do they foul?
There he is, the kid from Seattle Franklin High School. How important is this game? Well, if he takes his jersey and just pulls it a little bit over, he has tattooed on the numbers 206. That's the Seattle area code.
Absolutely. One of 10 kids. He's got 5 brothers and 4 sisters.
He said he had trouble with academics early in his career, but he got to Franklin High School and wound up with like a 3.8 GPA. He's a great kid. Watts trying to take Justin Wessel. Michael Johnson fumbled with it, but it found home. 5 points for Johnson, a 3, and now his first 2. Boy, they're denying Jason Terry all of the gaps.
What they do is once Terry gives up the ball, they overplay him and try to make it as difficult as possible for him to get the ball back.
We have a timeout on the floor. Defeat after they started conference play 0-3, 3 straight road conference games.
Steve, Washington has excellent spacing in their offense, which creates wide gaps, and there's what I'm talking about, and they're penetrating those gaps, and it's creating multitudes of problems for Arizona defensively.
Michael Wright again seals his man off and forces him to go over his back and knock it out of bounds. Bob Bender inside a minute to play with a good 9-point lead on Arizona, but the Wildcats and Jason Terry with the basketball.
Rudolph is not used to seeing teams freely penetrate his defense like Washington has here in the first half.
Shot clock at 20. Terry spins in the lane. What a shot. Off. Donald Watts at the control. They'll go for this final shot of the first half.
Well, Washington will bury everybody down on the baseline to get the defensive help out. Donald Watts will start his penetration at about 8. Here comes Luton. Jumper. Soft kiss made.
Beautifully done. Here's Terry at the buzzer. It goes! Jason Terry from Seattle Franklin High School almost went to play for the Huskies, and here with Arizona, he breaks their heart again.
Oh, Steve, look at the follow through. He carried that one right on through to the basket.
We've had a terrific first half, 45-39. Washington with the lead. University physiac George Raveling from Seattle, Washington. It is the Huskies by six as we check the first half stats. What jumps out at you, George?
Well, one thing is, I look over at Washington, they're down rebounding wise 24-20, but 10 of those 20 rebounds are offensive rebounds, and they converted six of the 10 offensive rebounds.
Well, Jason Terry will start the second half. Had 14 points in the first half, including a half-court shot as the buzzer sounded to end the first half. A.J. Bramlett gets it low, made just 3 of 10 shots first half, and this one doesn't find home. He's had some great looks. It just has not been fortunate for him tonight.
Arizona immediately going inside to Bramlett to try to secure the third foul on Todd McCullough.
And the ball knocked away. Michael Wright had some hand, had it in his hands, and then had it swapped away. Donald Watts. And again, Walcott takes it away, this time from Bramlett, and Todd McCullough scores. McCullough very quiet in the first half.
On those two shots, Arizona far too soft in going to the boards to rebound the backboard.
Todd McCullough only has 5 points in the game. He has made both of his field goal attempts, but A.J. Bramlett has just done a remarkable job defensively, not only tonight, but in Tucson. In Tucson, both of the field goals were scored by McCullough when Bramlett was on the sideline.
Boy, Chris Wilcox looks like a hockey player.
Terry in the lane scores. He's got 16.
Nice job of coming off the screen, catching, reading, taking the available offensive opportunity.
Beautiful backdoor cut by Deion Lewton and a nice feed by Chris Walcott.
Steve, we've seen substantial growth in this Husky team from January the 1st until today.
You know, you're absolutely right. When we saw them lose their first three conference games, all three in the road, things were looking ugly. But Watts has stepped up not only the game in this one, but also the last six contests where Arizona has seen Washington win five.
Well, the matchup is a little deceiving statistically because Donald Watts has contributed in a variety of areas that don't necessarily show on that statistical graph.
SenQ Carey, corner Deion Lewton for three.
Deion Lewton is on a roll right now. He's in his offensive rhythm. His self-talk is, I can lay him down. Get me the ball, give me some good looks, I'll put it in the hole for you.
He's got 17. Jefferson loses it, tries to swat it back, it goes out of bounds. It'll be Washington's basketball. Boy, they're scrambling for everything. One thing Bob Bender did not like the first three conference games was the fact the team wasn't hustling. They weren't getting loose balls, getting the offensive rebound, putting their body on the floor. They have the last month of the season. Boy, that Watts is a great first step, and he gets the roll.
Boy, if anybody from the NCAA is watching, selection committee's watching this game, they certainly have to be impressed with Washington. They're playing like an NCAA tournament team.
SenQ Carey. Arizona may have to take a timeout right here, and they do.
And Lute Olsen's almost out at half court. Very upset at Ricky Anderson on that last play. We now move into transition. Ball goes down. And Lute Olsen's upset at Ricky Anderson because he did not sprint back on defense.
Washington has their biggest lead, 56-41, a 15-point lead. And Washington, like they did to start the game, has made five of their first six shots.
And what Washington's done is they've built a substantial enough lead to guard against a couple bad offensive defensive decisions, and that it can also trade baskets with Arizona in here if necessary.
Ramlett loses it out of bounds, but it is off the hands of Senkew Carey, and it will be Arizona's basketball. But Ramlett and Wright have had very good looks at the hoop in the second half. They just have not had any fortune. AJ sets the screen. Terry takes the shot, misses short. Senkew Carey gets it.
And once again, Arizona finds difficulty in defending dribble penetration.
Senkew Carey, short. Jason Terry hustles it the other way. Jason one on three, waits for Michael Wright and A.J. Bramlett.
And not only did he wait for Michael Wright, he waited for a rebounder.
Lute Olson's got to think, I've got to get me some shooters out there. It is just not going down for Arizona to start this second half. They had 39 at the break. In the first 4 minutes of the second half, they only have 2 points.
The problem that Arizona experiences is they do not have a good jump shooting team on the floor, and as a result, their offense is built around Jason Terry's one-on-one and A.J. Bramlett and Wright down in the low post.
Bramlett's now 3 of 12 for the floor. And he's a 56% field goal shooter. Chris Walcott, he hits. Boy, they're getting some mighty good looks on offense.
And that's been the difference in the game offensively. Basketball is a game of easy shots. The team that secures the most easy shots usually wins.
Kicked out of bounds and got Deion Luton is still in pain on the sideline. Deion slow in getting up. We'll check his injury when we come back. That Washington bench very concerned about one of their best offensive players, Deion Luton, who turned his ankle diving for a ball on the sideline.
The chase out of bounds, the legs tangle up. There it is right there. Stepped on his ankle.
But he's staying in the game. Deion's back with a 17-point lead, and Luton has given him 17 points in this game. Bramlett gets it down low, turns to his left, and scores. He is now 4 for 13 from the floor.
With Todd McCullough only having 5 points, I think Washington sent a message to the rest of the league that we're not a team that's solely dependent on Todd McCullough for points or rebounds.
And here's a guy who has 5 points in the game. Travis Wilson's in the game, but McCullough only has 5 points. A.J. Bramlett has 8 points. McCullough's got 5, and they're up 17.
A good sign for Washington. And as I said, they're sending out a silent message that we're not dependent on any one player for our offensive success.
They scored 11 straight points in the last 3.5 minutes before the last bucket, but McCullough pushes the lead back to 17.
The reality is that Washington really has two other go-to players in Deion Luton and Donald Watt, so they have 3 go-to players.
Nice backdoor cut by Justin Russell. That gets it down to 15 again, still with plenty of time, 14.5 minutes left.
But see, Steve, what Arizona's got to do, they've got to weave some 3-point made baskets into their offense. They cannot continue.
Senkew Carey. It will not go down. this game, though. It has got grown and grown and grown so much. Jason Jarrett can't get it to go. McCullough with the rebound ahead to Donald Watts.
See, Arizona cannot continue to trade baskets with Washington.
Talking about they have to start defending better.
They have to come up with consecutive defensive stops, and then when they get down on the offensive end, every now and then they've got to weave a three-point made basket into their offense.
Washington's defensive rotation has been so good. Now they'll call a foul on Walcott, who kept on pushing Michael Wright out of the paint with his elbow. That's three fouls on Chris Walcott. Walcott will leave. In comes Thalo Green. Back Reuben Douglas for Arizona, and he'll take over for A.J. Bramble, so the Cats will go a little smaller.
Well, what they're going to do now, they're going to go with a three-guard offense. What you have on the floor now is a potent offensive team for Arizona.
Travis Wilson is fouled, and if the foul could have occurred against Eugene Edgerson or against Travis Wilson. If he fouled Wilson, Wilson will have three shots. It's the second foul against Donald Watts. So apparently he did foul Eugene Edgerson, so there will be no free throws. Travis Wilson taking it up strong, can't score. Eugene Edgerson battling for it. And he just muscles it up and gets the free throws. The third foul on Todd McCullough.
Nice power move. Actually, it might have been able to go the other way, as it appeared that Edgerson backed Todd McCullough out on that play.
You know, Eugene Edgerson is a little different. Here's one of the toughest guys in the conference. He wears knee pads, but he wears them around his shins. What's that all about?
Different strokes for different folks.
That's his soccer game. Todd McCullough now leaves the lineup with three fouls. Edgerson has done such a nice job growing as a free throw shooter, where he shot just above 40% as a freshman.
Both the score and the clock allowed Bob Binder to get Todd McCullough out of the game and give him a rest with three fouls.
Wide open, Donald Watts for three.
My player of the game thus far, Donald Watts. Everything Donald Watts has done in this game has been textbook.
A.J. Bramlett, meantime, goes low to cut it down to 14 points again.
Donald Watts has made some sterling decisions thus far in this game, both when he was at the point guard position and also when he's at the off guard position. He's really let the game come to him offensively.
Here's Luton. Nope. Bramlett has it with a chance to get it within 12.
But Steve, I continue to say, Arizona's got to mix some made three-point baskets in there.
Wilson inside. A.J. Bramlett misses short. Oh, and that was an easy layup. It would have been a 12-point game and a nice feed by Travis Wilson. Lou Olson can't believe it. He's saying A.J. just can't finish tonight. Watts. You know, I thought he picked up his pivot foot, but they're calling a foul prior to that.
When you talk about the outstanding players in the Pac-10, and there's certainly a wealth of them this year, here's a young man, Donald Watts, that tends to go overlooked. But when you look at off guards, he has all the physical skills and the intangibles that coaches look for in an off guard. He's tough off the dribble. He can shoot the three. He has good size for an off guard. And he makes good decisions.
Bob Bender said it is the most satisfying player development in his coaching career. Under scrutiny and expectations, he has worked hard to emerge as one of the best in the Pac-10 conference. Donald Watson has popped slick. Washington with a 15-point lead on the number 10 rated team in the nation, the Arizona Wildcats. And let's take a GTE academic salute to Tad McCullough, who has a 3.13 grade point average in speech and hearing science. A 7-foot center from Winnipeg, Manitoba. He has 7 points tonight, has not missed a field goal, but he's been in foul trouble first half, hasn't played that many minutes, still with 8 rebounds. Arizona going with Wilson, Terry backcourt, Rick Anderson, A.J. Bramlett, Gene Edges in front line. Arizona seeing Washington counter with Greg Clark, Baylor Green, and Bramlett will get fouled. It'll be Clark Green with Carey, Luton, and Michael Johnson is now in the game. Foul goes against Baylor Green, and that will be his first personal foul. Just his first, and there is A.J. Bramlett has a time from the field.
Steve, the object of offense is simple. Get the ball to the right player at the right time and score. Anything other than that is just window dressing.
He misses both foul shots, but Travis Wilson gets it back and scores. That will cut it to 13 at 64-51.
The storyline in the second half of this game is the fact that Jason Terry has not scored since 18:50 of the second half.
He had 14 in the first half, has 2 in the second half. Rick Anderson ahead to Travis Wilson. Wilson has it knocked away by Senkew Carey, and then a foul is called on Senkew, his third.
Nice jump stop, penetration. Okay, the foul was not called on the shot attempt. It was called on the rebound.
Well, you're talking about Mr. Terry. He must have heard you. Everything you say always kind of gives him a little challenge to go with.
Well, this is about as good a defensive job as I've seen anybody in the Pac-10 do on Jason Terry this season.
Deion Luton may have forced it. Eugene Edgerson with the rebound into the hands of Terry. Here come the Wildcats and the Electric Man.
Do you think he overheard us, Steve?
We have seen too much of him to think that they're going to hold him down for that long. Jason Terry, the leading candidate to win the Pac-10 Player of the Year. Meantime, Arizona has got it down to 9, Coach. Jason Terry has scored back-to-back field goals.
Well, when I was a youngster, my grandma used to say, you can't keep a good man down. And she might as well said, you can't keep a good basketball player down.
You can't keep Jason Terry down.
He's a good one.
He is a very good one.
But this conference has a lot of wonderful players. And a lot of wonderful coaches.
Senkew Carey, shot clock still shows plenty of time, 15 seconds left. Michael Johnson gets the roll and has a chance for a 3-point play. This is one of his better games. He's got 7 points.
Johnson, he sees he has Rick Anderson on him. He puts the ball on the dribble. He's going to challenge Anderson and make Anderson prove that he can defend dribble penetration.
And Michael Johnson pushes that lead back to 12 with the old-fashioned 3-point play. Carey will stay on Terry. Pick and roll. Bramlett was rolling the hoop. They didn't see him. Terry takes it himself, so that's the pick and roll. I'll see you later and take the shot myself.
But Terry realized it's getting down to crunch time now. His self-talk is, I have to take over this game if, in fact, we're going to win. If we're going to make a substantial comeback. I've got to lead it.
Terry has Arizona's last three hoops. Let's see if he gets another. Edgerson dove when he threw the pass at Jason. Here goes Terry, stutter step dribble with the fade. Not this time, but Edgerson is there.
Terry's taking over the offense right now for Arizona. He said, all right, I tried to get everybody involved. I got to go in a different direction.
After the last break, when Terry walked on the floor, Lute Olson pointed at him. I don't know if that was you take it or let's do something, pal. This is Donald Watts with the turn. No. Rebound, A.J. Bramlett. Travis Wilson is fouled. Is a foul on Donald Watts. Meantime, let's check out Jason Terry's last play.
Jason Terry, nice crossover, spin, lift. Jason Terry really gets up well on his turnaround jump shot. Now, he's certainly not the quality of player as Michael Jordan, but he reminds me of Michael Jordan on that turnaround jump shot. He has the same kind of lift.
Oh, please, not, let's not compare anyone with MJ.
No, I'm just talking about lift on the jump shot.
Donald Watts picked up his third personal foul. Travis Wilson is at the free throw line, and he is only, well, he's a 68% foul shooter. Not bad for a freshman. Missed his first badly. Greg Clark will come out of the game. Back in, Chris Wolcott. Wilson makes the second. It is a 7-point game at the 8:55 mark.
That 15-point lead is starting to evaporate as Jason Terry takes command of the Wildcat offense.
One time it was a 17-point lead at the 14-and-a-half-minute mark of this second half. But Donald Watts, this is the man who's got to get him going back.
Steve, offensive runs are initiated at the defensive end of the floor.
Great pass, Johnson, it is blocked by Michael Wright. Wolcott gets it back. A steal by A.J. Bramlett. Yes, it will be Arizona's basketball. Lute Olson has it going his way. Is Washington feeling the pressure? Michael Wright, strong move to the hoop.
That was a set play call from the bench. Lute Olson saw the matchup. Wolcott on right. He immediately called for the two-play.
Wolcott was trying to look for Todd McCullough, but he was so well defended by A.J. Bramlett, he had to rotate that basketball. Carey. Oh, tough shot by Sekou Carey.
And the way Curry was able to secure that shot was he used his body and leaned in.
Michael Wright! Look at that. His face shows nothing. Like it was somebody just dunked on him or he dunked on them. Arizona with a 16-4 run the last 4:15. That's the man who's got to get Washington going. Donald Watts.
Well, if you watch this play from its origin, you'll see that we have poor defensive post help there. I think if A.J. Bramlett had to do it all over again, he would have stayed up high on McCullough, stepped out and helped, and prevented the dribble penetration by Donald Watts.
So Watts, who has 16 points in the ballgame, give him 17. Watts with 17, Luton with 17, and it is the Huskies with the 8-point lead. In the middle of that Husky huddle is Todd McCullough. He just went over to the officials, and Coach, what was he talking about?
What he did, Steve, he went over to the official, he visited with him, he said, sir, please watch A.J. Bramlett. He's grabbing me by the wrist as I try to secure inside post position. And here's a good example of it. Excellent camera work by our crew here. There he is, he's holding him. He continues to hold, he's wrapping his arm around him. And McCullough saying, sir, it's a little tough to catch the ball when you're being held.
McCullough has three fouls. A.J. Bramlett has two fouls. Syracuse Carey, along with Donald Watts. Watts knocks it away. Richard Jefferson, 4-3.
It's getting interesting, Steve, as we close in on 5 minutes.
Getting real interesting. A 5-point lead for Washington. They had one time in the second half led by 17.
It'll be interesting to see if Washington becomes tentative offensively or if they just continue to play.
McCullough forced that one. He goes down hard. Scrambling for the loose basketball is Donald Watson, Richard Jefferson. The possession arrow will give it back to Washington, but I'm telling you what, this place shook when McCullough hit the floor.
Well, I'll tell you this, if I were ever on an elevator with McCullough, I'd hope it's going down.
I'll tell you what, you'll get down in a hurry.
He's a big hunk.
7 feet, 275 pounds.
And that's on a good day.
Come on. Here's Donald Watts. He's got Bramlett defending him now. Watts turned around and flipped under him, picks up the third foul by Bramlett. You know, I think if you time Donald in a 40-yard dash, he may not be the fastest on the team, but he has unbelievable first-step quickness.
Well, he has a big, wide stride when he lays that first dribble down. If you were to run that in slow-mo, you'd see what a wide stride he has as he secures that first step to the basket.
Luton and Watts. Wilson rotates over on Donald. Send you carry with the basketball. They high low to Todd McCullough.
Washington cleared everybody off the baseline. They walked Todd McCullough up the lane because he knew he was going to be fronted, and they threw over top of the defense. There was no help by Arizona. Washington, they cleared it out.
Look at that guy. Jason Terry somehow finds a little crease in the crack, and he sneaks in. He's got 24 points now. And here comes Terry the other way, a 2-on-2. Jefferson to his right. Terry's going to take it himself. Jefferson gets it back, can't score. That was a big miss.
That was a huge miss there. Steve, that would have cut it to 3 points.
Bramlett to Terry. Here he goes against Syracuse Carey. Will he pick up the foul? Nobody misses the shot. And we're going the other way. They're calling a personal foul against Jason Terry, his second. And Lute Olson is livid. Well, Jason Terry is the subject of our 7-Up pop quiz. He leads the Pac-10 with 21.5 points per game. Who holds the Arizona season record for point average? We will give you the answer later in the game. Jefferson defending Luton. Nearing the 5-minute mark.
Arizona's done a nice job of taking away triple penetration in the second half, and that's been a big key to Arizona's defense, Steve. A nice adjustment by Lute Olson.
And Richard Jefferson with a nice save and timeout call. 5:04 remains. Let's give the answer to that 7-Up pop quiz. I'm wondering who was it. I'm guessing it was Khalid Reeves. And the answer is 24.2 in 93-94. He was in the backcourt with Damon Stoudemire, and were they an excellent pair.
Boy, Arizona's had their fair share of quality guards over the years.
Jason Terry, Mike Bibby, Damon Stoudemire, Steve Kerr, Khalid Reeves. They're getting a kid next year who's fabulous from Indiana, from Indianapolis. Jason Gardner. Also got Gilbert Arenas from Southern California. Got a transfer, Lauren Woods from Wake Forest. They reload. Stripped by Carey. It went off the knee of Senkou Carey.
Steve, this is a huge possession for Arizona now. Two cuts it to three. Three cuts it to two. And all of a sudden, it's a new ball game.
Richard Jefferson slashing in. He hits. It's a three-point game. Great comeback by Arizona, down 17 at the 14-and-a-half minute mark of this ball game.
And what the comeback has done, Steve, it's taken the crowd out of the game.
Watch knows he's got to do something. Luton. For three.
First shot Deion Luton's had in a long, long time.
He was stuck on 17 and now has 20. You might remember he turned the ankle and hadn't scored until that three. Jason Terry misses the three. He's missed his last three shots. Michael Wright. This guy reminds me of Ben Davis. Walcott will pick up his fourth foul as Michael Wright just bulls his way for the rebound.
He reminds you of Ben Davis. He reminds me of former NBA player Michael Cage, who played down at San Diego State.
The old southpaw.
Reminds me of him in physical stature and in ability.
Similar numbers, 16 and 10. Michael, a 77% foul shooter, drops the first and cuts the lead to five. And Michael Cage had that same poker face. Makes them both. 18 and 10 for the freshman from Chicago Farragut Academy.
Offensively, the Huskies need to spread the offense, create driving gaps. Arizona needs a defensive stop and a conversion.
Shot clock now down to 10. Senkou Carey on the drive, tried to kick it back to Todd McCullough, but Carey was pushed as he swept along that baseline. Here is Senkou Carey. Really, their fortunes turned around when Carey turned around. They lost Dan Dick out for the season, their starting point guard, with a foot problem. Carey took over, and well, he has just been a terrific player in the starts that he's made. He's averaging 14 points per game. He has 13.
I think the word that best captures Curry's performance since he became a starter, Steve, is consistency.
Both offensively and defensively. Look at that. Last seven games as a starter. Carey misses the second, but McConnell pulls a rebound. And then it's kicked out of bounds by Washington. It'll be Arizona's basketball. With 3:32 left in the ball game, Huskies by five. Arizona is down by 5 points, 78-73. One of the reasons for their comeback has been their success on the boards. A.J. Bramlett has 15 rebounds, and he has, again, done a fine defensive job on Todd McCullough.
And, Steve, just about half of Arizona's rebounds have been offensive rebounds. They've secured 22 offensive rebounds.
There's that same play, and it's Michael Wright trying to roll it in. He misses the three-point play opportunity. He will go to the foul line for two shots. And for Chris Walcott, he has just fouled out of the game.
Michael Wright, for a young freshman, does a nice job of securing low post position. He gets a wide base. He seals his defender. Makes it easy to get the ball inside to him.
So Walcott is gone. He's one of their leaders. Thalo Green, a poor foul shooter, comes in. But for Wright, isn't it interesting, the last two timeouts, Lute Olson comes out with plays designed for this freshman?
Well, I think a couple reasons. One, he's an excellent low post player at securing position. Number two, he's a good foul shooter. So the chances of you coming away with some points are pretty good.
He makes one of two. The lead is four for Washington.
And right now, the time, the score, the game demands good decision making and solid team defense by both teams.
Terry stays in the floor for Arizona with Bramlett, Wilson, Wright, and Jefferson. Thalo Green with Watts, Carey, McCullough, and Luton for Washington. 3 minutes to go. Shot clock is down to 11.
You want to get up on Luton right now if you're Arizona and make him work off the dribble.
Here's Watts. He was bumped. Nothing called. McCullough got it and gets fouled. That hit about three Arizona hands and went right to Todd McCullough.
Boy, the bodies are really banging in there. You talk about this being a non-contact sport, forget it.
The foul went against Richard Jefferson, his third, so McCullough is at the free throw line, a 62% foul shooter. Conley drops the first. He had that remarkable game for Bob Bender on Sunday where they beat UCLA by 10 points. McCullough with 26 points and 21 rebounds.
Once again, it's time for Jason Terry to step up and take over the offensive leadership.
Jefferson to Bramlett. He misses the shot. Well, they executed it perfectly. They just couldn't get it to drop.
A.J. Bramlett has missed some unbelievably easy shots in this game, and I know he's thoroughly disgusted at himself.
He's having one of those games where, well, Mom said you'd have nights like these. Sometimes you throw the ball in the Pacific Ocean and it rims around the Aleutian Islands.
Sounds serious to me.
They'll work the clock. Watts will work it down to 10 seconds and then run the offense. Senkew Carey misses the long three and it goes out of bounds. No, it doesn't. Saved by Deion Luton.
And Bob Bender's telling them to take it back out. Work the clock.
Watts struggling with it. Stolen by Terry. No, by Wilson. Where's Jason? There he is. Short. Bramlett. Yes.
If at first you don't succeed, try and try again.
And there's another one of those offensive rebounds you were talking about.
Well, time and time again, Steve, Washington has failed to block out on the offensive boards.
But the Huskies with a four-point lead. They beat top-rated UCLA on Sunday. Can they knock off number 10 Arizona just 4 days later? Watts trying to get them closer. A season best for Donald Watts with 19 points.
Donald Watts is very difficult to guard off the dribble. Time and time again in this game, he has made the right decision at the offensive end of the court, whether it be get the ball inside, hit a cutter coming off a screen, or take it to the hole one-on-one.
Donald Watts with a three-point play has 20 points. Arizona with the basketball nearing the one-minute mark. Terry with everybody on him has it knocked away, and there's that man again. Donald Watts. He saved it in the corner. The official said he stepped on the sideline, so Bob Bender will watch Arizona get it again. Here's Terry. Well, he got up quickly and drops it home to cut it to five with 55.9 seconds left. The Huskies trying to win number 13 when we come back. Each team with 9 fouls. If there's a held ball, Arizona will get it. Wildcats have just 1 timeout left. Washington has 2. What do you do if you're Lute Olson and the Wildcats?
Well, the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to press. You're going to put supreme pressure on the inbound thrower. Number 2, you're probably going to take a foul on the poorest foul shooter before the ball gets to half court. The first thing you're going to hope to do is get a steal. Okay, there we are. There it is.
And Jason Terry can't score. Richard Jefferson can. And all of a sudden, it's a 3-point game with 50 seconds left. Executed perfectly. Washington's getting a little nervous. Washington has a 3-point lead over Arizona. At one time, the Huskies lead was 17. And a reminder that Fox Sports News will be coming your way next. There's Todd McCullough. Let's see if Washington tries to go to him. There's one player on the floor for the Huskies, Thalo Green, that is a minus 50% foul shooter, and he is not even near the play being entered.
Steve, Arizona has no more timeouts. The only way they can stop the clock now is to foul.
Terry went for the steal, missed it, and they will foul Donald Watts, one of the best foul shooters.
They probably waited a little too long to foul.
AJ!
Well, they went for the steal with Senkew Carey, and when they didn't get that, as soon as he passed it, Donald Watts was fouled. There's the first to make it a 2-possession game.
I wouldn't at all be surprised to see Washington extend its defense at least to 3-quarter court to prevent Arizona from walking the ball into their offense. Nope.
Terry scores down low to make it a 3-point game again, 85-82. Senkew Carey is fouled right away by Richard Jefferson. And Jefferson, as soon as Terry made the ball, looked over at Coach Lute Olson. Olson said, "You've got a foul, son," and he does.
Well, the theory being, if you're going to foul someone out there, always try to put a freshman on the line.
Remember, it was Senkew Carey at the free throw line in Tucson. He made 1 of 2 foul shots that gave them a 2-point lead. Terry came down, missed his jumper, and Richard Jefferson would tip it in to give the Wildcats a win. The lead is 3 here as Lute Olson, with a player fouling out, he's taking as much time as he can to get Michael Wright and Justin Wessel in the game.
Well, and the reason that Lute Olson's doing that, he's trying to keep Senkew Carey thinking about the importance of making these fouls.
Wessel was trying to come in. And what they're doing now, I'll bet this was all designed to let Senkew Carey think a little longer at the free throw line.
Hey, Lute Olson's not a Hall of Fame coach for nothing.
He has no timeouts left, so he couldn't make Senkew think by calling a 20 or a full. Here's the freshman from Northern California.
First one's the most important.
So it's a two-possession game. Wessel comes in for Edgerson. Again, Fox Sports News primetime is coming up after the completion of this game. Ice.
Put the ball in Jason Terry's hand. Race it up. Score. If you score, foul.
Terry misses the three. It goes out of bounds to Washington with a five-point lead and just 21 seconds left.
And Arizona has no timeout, so it's difficult to stop the clock. Lute Olson puts a sub in, which allows Arizona an opportunity to get their defense set. Lute pulling out all of his chest plays.
And a foul against either Reuben Douglas or Travis Wilson. It will go against Travis Wilson. And Travis Wilson has fouled out of the game. Washington has lost 11 straight versus top 10 teams. They beat number 11 New Mexico and number 11 UCLA this year. But in the 1990s, Washington has a record of 3-20 against top 10 opponents. All three teams are the Arizona Wildcats.
Well, in the Associated Press poll, Arizona's sitting at 10 this week. In the USA Today poll, they're sitting at 11.
This would be a huge win to get them into the NCAA tournament. You remember last year, Washington made the tournament with a record of 18-9 and 11-7. The Huskies have 9 games left to win 6 and match last year's total. They have 5 on the home, 4 on the road. It'll be 4-4 after tonight. Senkew Carey. He misses his first. May be raining outside, but this young man has had ice in his veins tonight in the second half.
Two-possession game. This is going to be tough. You need a three here. You need a three.
USC did it with 2.6 seconds left against Oregon. Reuben Douglas misses the three. It's popped around and won by Washington.
Hit by
Donald Watts. Washington Huskies spoil the Jason Terry homecoming as Slick Watts, son Donald, is our player of the game. Washington improves a record of 13-7, 6-4 in conference play. Arizona falls to 15-4, 7-3 in conference play. But that's a mighty big win for the Huskies.
And all of a sudden, Stanford now has a 2-game lead.
Todd McCullough was shut down, but Lute Olson could not do anything with Donald Watts and Deion Luton, who contributed so mightily in this game to a 6-point win over the number 10 rated team in the nation, the Arizona Wildcats. It is Washington winning tonight, 90-84 over the Arizona Wildcats. So for my partner, George Raveling, and the rest of our Fox Sports Net crew who did an outstanding job in Seattle, I'm Steve Fizioc saying so long from Seattle, Washington, where the final score again, Washington 90, Arizona 84.